Hello my dear students, welcome back to my session on SolidWorks in 21 days. We are on day 14. In today's session we will see about some basics about sheet metal. This will be useful for understanding the subject called the development of surfaces, which is a topic coming under the first semester or first year engineering graphics subject across India. So here in this exercise I'll be attaching two files. EX20 is a sheet metal about a cylinder, EX21 exercise 21 a sheet metal of a cone. Let me open a SolidWorks file, a part file. I am going to solve about the first problem, the sheet metal of a cylinder. The difference between solid cylinder and the sheet metal cylinder is solid cylinder is a solid member, solid it has volume, but under this it's a sheet metal. The cylinder is made out of a sheet metal, that means it is having using a thin sheet of steel sheet. By rolling it I'll be getting the cylinder. That means the circle that I'll be drawing, you know, it should not be a perfect, it should not be a closed circle. Small slit, small cut or a slit, yeah, we have to introduce. Well, let us see. Let me start with drawing a circle of say diameter 60. Now it is a full circle, but for a sheet metal to develop it, it should not be a closed profile, it should be open profile. I'll make a small cut of a gap of just 0.5, just 0.5. I want this to be construction line type, this center and this center. Horizontal relation is made, that is why if you see already horizontal relation is made already. Once again I'll show you. If I again selecting those two, if I go for if we do vertical, you see it is power defined, it will not allow you, it will not allow you. Okay, so horizontal relation is made. So using the trim command, actually I cut the circle, actually I cut the circle, it is not a cut, it is no longer a circle now, it is an arc, actually arc of radius 30. Okay, you see some small opening is there. Okay, then go to insert, sheet metal, base flange. Okay, so now let me set the height as 80. Press enter, that's it. So in this dialog box, again I repeat, I have chosen insert, sheet metal, base flange. You see there is a small opening. If you see the top view, is a small opening here, a small opening. Okay, so with that only, with this edge only, we'll be unwrapping and wrapping, rolling and unrolling. Now let me introduce flatten. Again insert, sheet metal, unfold. About this inner edge, maybe inner edge, outer edge, inner edge, this surface, the outer surface. Okay, now it is flattened. So what will be the this length? This is pi d, diameter 60, no? If pi is say 3 approximately, so pi, that 60 into 3 times. 3.14 is the pi value. Okay, so let us check. So 188, yes, 188, 3.14 into 60, the diameter, pi d, circumference. Now you see the length 188. Now let me, it is unfolded, let me fold it again. Here unfold, in the descent tree unfold icon is the entity is added. Now if you unsuppress or suppress, if I suppress it be rolled. Again if you unsuppress, click the unfold, unsuppress, unfolded, click suppress, folded. So this is how you can make. So it's a very simple thing, but let me introduce some more things here. Let me roll back. Okay, let me roll back that I rolled back unfold thing. That means it cannot be unfolded now. Now after at this particular point, let me introduce a sketch to make some holes here. I may use dimension, I may not be using the dimensions, doesn't matter. Okay, so a circle here, let me say all the diameters of all these are equal. So this side, this side, this is centrally made, this circle is centrally made. The radius is 30, no, diameter 60, radius is 30. Let this be 24, 27 or something. Okay, it should not cross, so I slightly move this way. Okay, so now you see a circle is drawn at the center, central plane, on this front plane. Now I want to cut through this direction as well as that direction. Cut through all this direction. Then in direction 2 also through all. It'll take some time. Yeah, cut is made. Now in this view it is seen as a circle. But if we see that it will be a oval like shape about these two. This one, this. Whereas this will be a ellipse actually. Okay, so this is how I made the hole. Now let me move down the rollback bar. Now let me go for suppress, sorry, unsuppress, unfold, get flattened. You see how the holes are. Actually after folding in front view, all these three holes are seems to be perfect circle. It is supposed to be seen as a perfect circle. Upon folding, upon unfolding, you see that how it behaves. So I think this kind of thing is not that easy. That cannot be. This is coming under the development of surfaces, right? So this cannot be explained so easily like this. Okay, so it can be taught so easily with the help of the parametric modeling softwares like SolidWorks. Not only in SolidWorks, also other parametric modeling softwares like ProE, Creo, CATIA, Unigraphics, NX2, even those things also that has these features. Okay, let me save this as exercise 20. exercise 20. Okay. Even you can try this also. Unsuppress. You can get this as a drawing also. Okay. So it is unfolded. Go to new drawing file. The current model view, hidden lines removed, the scale is 1:1. So this is the development. Let me save this as, instead of saving it as drawing file, I can save it as drawing file, EX20 drawing file. You can open this in the AutoCAD. Now let me check. Yeah, here, EX20 drawing file. If you double click this one, it will be opened in the AutoCAD, right? So the development of that one can be obtained here. Okay, let me close this. Let me suppress this also. So this is the front view, side view, top view, asymmetric view. Save it. So this is over. We'll see the other exercise 21. Let me save this as this is 20, no? Let me save this as 21. Then let me delete all those things. So let this be as such, because we'll be seeing a cone, you know. So cone means a perfect cone. For a solid cone, base is a circle, apex is a point, but it is not a solid here, it is a sheet metal. So a small cut should be there. That is the start and end. We'll be wrapping or folding and unfolding. So there should be some opening, number one. Number two, apex should not be a point. Again, it should be a small circle with a slit, with a cut. Okay, so already this is having a circle of base diameter of 60. A small opening is there. In the same way, this is drawn on top plane. I chose top plane. I have to create another reference plane. So another reference plane I'll be introducing, maybe at the height of 80 mm. Okay. Let me hide the plane. Whenever I select the plane, that time alone, if it is visible, then it is okay. Now plane is visible. Go there. You have a small let this be the diameter as say 1.6 or so, then small slit let me introduce. This is sufficient. Test construction, then let me cut it. This portion I cut. Now escape, I exit from the sketch. So two sketches are made. Here is the sketch. Sketch one. This is sketch one, sketch two, and this is sketch one. Okay. So I think let me choose both. Go for insert, sheet metal, lofted bend, press OK. press OK. Everything is alright, press OK. Now the exercise number 21, you see it's a hollow. If I see the section profile, if you in the section it will be visible. It is not a solid part, it's a hollow part. It's a hollow part. Okay, so let me save it. Now use the other parameter called under sheet metal, the unfold. Unfold, choose this edge, the surface. Okay, now upon unfolding you'll get a sector, you'll get a sector. Then suppress it, you'll get a cone. Upon folding you get a cone. Let me roll back. Then with respect to this plane, let me draw this time a pentagon, maybe this time a pentagon. I'm not using any dimensions. Okay, so pentagon is drawn in the middle. So if you use a cut through this side and that side through all, you'll get a pentagonal slot hole through all this that direction, right side direction, in the left side direction also through all. That's it. Okay, what happened? Cut text to okay, let me erase. Let me introduce a cut. Cut. Through all. Through all. Why I'm not getting the hole now? Yeah, okay, now I got a hole. Now I got a hole. A hole is made. Now this is the front view, this is the side view, maybe this is the top view and isometric view. Now let me expand. Let me go for unsuppressing the unfold. It gets flattened. Now see the profile. This is a profile. Suppress front view. Let me introduce another hole at the top. Please, let's see what happens. Another sketch in the front plane. This time I'll be drawing a circle here, then through all, through all. A circular hole is made, also made. Okay, roll back, expand everything. Now hole is also made. Now let us see unsuppress. This is how you see, actually the hole is a circular hole, but upon developing it as a sheet metal, it is neither a circle nor ellipse. It is something like a different profile you'll be getting. So these two files will be available to you in a zip file attached as a link under the description. I'll show you some of the other things also here for your visualization only. Development of development of surfaces and development of pentagonal pyramid. What we have seen now is a cylinder and cone, you know. So this is the pentagonal pyramid with a circular hole. Answer press, you will get a flat sheet. It is on a pyramid. Let us see the prism also. Let us see the prism also. Pentagonal prism. The pentagonal prism, circular hole. Answer press. So get flattened. This is the view. Suppress, it is folded. Okay, so in my view, actually I normally use the SolidWorks software for developing some parts and machines actually. But this particular session is dedicated exclusively for learning the development of surfaces topic coming under engineering graphics subject. Okay, so thank you so much. Please subscribe my channel, then inform this to others also, so other students and faculty members, those who are handling this subjects, and those who want to become a CAD engineer. So for those persons, my sessions will be really useful to them. Thank you.